Hi everyone, my name is Lisa Tarmati and this is my mum, Isabel Margaret Tarmati from New Zealand. And we're here to tell you a little bit about our cancer journey. So mum, can you tell them a little bit, what type of cancer did you have? Was it in the brain or where was it?
I had a lymphoma in the brain, which you could clearly see.
Yep.
And they said that they would take it out, which was good. And they did successfully.
Yep, beautiful.
I didn't lose my speech or anything, which was what I was concerned about.
Yeah. So mum was diagnosed at the age of 80, basically with a CNS lymphoma, a very aggressive form of lymphoma. And once they had taken the main tumour out, there was one big one and some little ones, they realised, yeah, what it was, and we got the full diagnosis. From the time of the diagnosis, I was very aware of the metabolic approach to cancer. I'd done some research prior to her diagnosis. So I immediately changed her diet and she went full keto diet and exogenous ketones in the mix. And then as I started to study and uncover all of the studies around metabolic approach to cancer, I studied Dr. Dom D'Agostino's work, Jay McClellan's work, the care oncology team's work, Volta Longo's work, many, many scientists. And the upshot of it was that we adopted this approach. I developed a number of protocols after all my study in conjunction with a number of doctors around the world. You know, I found it really frustrating that my local oncologists, hematologists were completely unaware of the metabolic approach. In fact, by the last visit I had, they said, oh, Isabel, you better start eating some more pudding to keep your weight up. And I thought, yeah, that really pretty much sums up their knowledge of metabolic approach. But within 8 weeks of having the surgery, we managed to turn it around from a terminal diagnosis within the next few months to absolute total resolution of the tumours, according to the last MRI. Now, you never want to say you're cured because cancer can be very tricky in that respect. But we are doing a combination of off-label drugs. So things like doxycycline, metformin, atorvastatin, mebendazole, valproate, dichloroacetate, 2-deoxyglucose, a number of other things in the mix, and a whole lot of natural health supplements. So she is on probably around about 150 pills a day, which, you know, do you find that a bit tough, mum?
Oh, yes, I've got to sit there and swallow them all. But it's not as tough as going down with cancer.
Exactly. That's our approach too. We're also lucky enough to have a hyperbaric oxygen therapy chamber in our house just behind us. We have that. So she goes in there pretty much every day. She also has intravenous vitamin C 2 to 3 times a week, quite high dosages. We did that according to the Reardon protocol. To turn around in 8 weeks from being told we're terminal, there's nothing that they can do from a conventional medicine point of view except high dose methotrexate, which I turned down, to then actually having a resolution so far of the tumors is fantastic. Now, we also have put into the mix, after me fighting and working it out, a particular type of immunotherapy and so rituximab and temozolomide we have put into the mix, and so we have now started those rounds as well, just to make sure that we really kick this thing out the door. I also did something called the RGCC gene test, which really gave us an idea of the gene mutations that were involved with hers as well. So we didn't discount that completely, and we have thrown that into the mix. I do believe that, you know, this is a very much a metabolic disease first and foremost that causes these gene mutations. And so by attacking it on multiple fronts, we hope to, you know, stay cancer free. So, and mum has had a background of an aneurysm prior to this 6 years ago, when we were also told what, mum, back then?
This is it.
You're never going to come back.
Yeah, not coming back.
Yeah. And at that point, she was like a baby, unable to speak, no idea who she was, what she was, unable to control any of her bodily functions. It took me 3 years to get her back to full health after that journey. So I was very much aware that our, you know, local medical system was not up to the task and that I'd better look further afield. So I'm very, very grateful for all those researchers, scientists, doctors who are promoting and sharing this information about the metabolic approach, because it certainly saved her life, and these people that think outside the square. So, you know, you're enjoying life now, Mum, are you?
Yeah, I mean, I've been swimming in the Auckland River today.
Yeah.
Still able to do exciting things that I grew up with.
Yeah.
Mostly.
Yeah.
Yeah. I get a bit frustrated sometimes.
More with the aneurysm and stroke side of things, yeah. With a couple of problems. But, you know, she's very, very healthy overall. So we're very happy, and she gets to enjoy her grandchildren and her family and have a really good quality of life. So thanks to everyone out there, and don't give up is the message. Even when you've been given a terminal prognosis, we had three doctors in the last few months tell us that she's terminal. And every time my mum has come walking out of the office and I've said to you, Mum, please don't listen to any of that. And she, what was your response to that?
No. I won't.
You won't listen to that? No. And why?
Because they don't know what I know. I know you. I know your ability to dig and find out the answers. So they don't know that.
They don't know everything is the answer, eh? They don't know everything. And so therefore we just take what we can get from that side of the fence, and then we take what we can get from the other side of the fence. And the moral of the story is to absolutely never give up. We've actually written a book called Relentless, telling the first journey of bringing you back from an aneurysm, and that was also about never giving up and being really persistent and having the mental toughness to keep going no matter what. So thanks everybody, and greetings from New Zealand.
Bye.